girl is. They keep showing her throughout this whole entire, like, show so far. Like, it started out with her and everything. Like, and I don't even know what's her...
This episode?
Yeah, like, she victim to or what? Or she's gonna be the girl they find underneath the gas station.
Maybe.
Hello everyone, my name is Cathy.
And I'm Long. Today we're going to be watching episode 5 of Blackbird. Do you remember what happened at the end? Episode 4?
I think they're trying to, his dad died, right?
The actor passed away, yes.
Oh.
I don't know if he finished finished shooting everything first. But, the killer's brother came in and told them that, hey, they're poking around at the house.
Yeah.
And usually when that happens, it means that they're desperate because your time's...
Your sentence is coming up soon. And they're saying that he might be released within like a month.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they're like, we need something now. Yeah, like, yeah. You need to like hurry
they're
up.
They're trying everything that they can to find anything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My grandmother died.
Oh, yeah.
I had never met her, so her death didn't mean much to me. Though it made my father very sad.
Aww.
I was afraid of her in that coffin. She was part of something that, even at 6, I wondered about. The place after this one.
Because I know they had that riot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But also, like, I don't know what happened to that cop guy. Because he needed that money. Mm. I don't know what happened to him. But he was threatening him.
Yeah. I haven't seen him in a bit.
I know. What's going on?
I think they might know that he's a snitch. Not a snitch, but a cop. No, not a cop. He's not a cop. A snitch.
Yeah. Just a snitch.
Oh, that's just in his head. That's cool. That's a really cool way to show that.
Where's Dr. Zuckerman? Excuse me. Where's Dr. Zuckerman?
He's on vacation.
How'd you know I'd be here?
Routine schedule is foundational in the doctor-patient relationship.
But how did you know I'd be here?
I don't understand the question.
But Dr. Zuckerman and I don't have a routine. How did you know I had an appointment today?
We have a daily schedule. I'm not in law enforcement. I'm not a judge. I don't concern myself with the crimes of the men I treat. My sole concern is protecting their mental health.
Sounds like you found your purpose in life.
Some people's psyches are so much more fragile than most people you've probably encountered in your life. Or your own, for example.
How do you know anything about my psyche?
But some of my patients are not. They're... One wrong thought. One termite of an unhealthy idea from losing their minds. If they break, sometimes the person they were never comes back from the break. They become ghosts in their own bodies. I'm asking you for compassion when you deal with some of the men in here.
Some of the men. Patience.
Wow. Dress is all wet. You know why?
Mm-hmm. After they buried my grandmother, my father drove us to the ocean. It it was the only time I would ever see the ocean.
You want some?
When they were looking, Patricia, right? Larry drove Marion PD up and down these roads over and over again.
I think I buried her here. No, it was here. Maybe it was there.
She's on another show that I was watching. The one with
so dragged him back out a second time. Son of a bitch, couldn't get enough of it.
Hold on. Hold on.
Let me see if I can get my hands on these reports.
No happened.
That counselor?
Huh?
Feels like he's a post threat to one of her clients. So she had him escorted to her office. Make him look like he's like a threat to everybody else. So that way, it's kind of like tell him to like shush, you know?
Yeah.
That's my assumption about. God, he's so ripped.
Well, good morning, James.
Morning, Larry. It was nice to see family. See any cars too?
A little. Well, not like me.
But the Civil War stuff?
He didn't stick with it.
Oh. Well, that's a shame.
He married a stinky bitch.
Oh.
So I said to her, I said, you would be a grandmother in Civil War times. An old hag. Nobody would fight for her. Brides were young. Unspoiled. My great-grandmother had my grandmother when she was just 14. That was perfectly normal back then.
Mm.
Until the government saw a way to make money.
By raising the age of consent?
Exactly. But once the government saw that there was money to be made in high schools, well, then greed trumps all. And it's not about education.
No?
No, it's about forcing kids to delay growing up. So that their parents can spend every extra dime on tuition, and everyone makes money, and that's what's going to bankrupt the country someday.
You know, I never thought about it that way.
Same.
Damn. You could be onto something.
Listen.
Fresh perspective. So these brides were how young?
12. 13 for sure.
Old enough to be old enough for me, right? It's the youngest you ever had.
What?
Oh my god.
You first.
Why ask first?
You first.
14.
Did she fight back?
No. You had some fighters. She was a freshman. I was a senior, so 17.
17.
Larry.
Oh, is it still dripping?
Drips turned into leaks.
Jesus. Every single time.
He had him drive up and down 400 East several times. 440 South is mentioned four times, so is 250.
Maybe they stopped for sodas and bathroom breaks.
I doubt that gas station was there, then it looked pretty new.
So what was there?
Construction at 550-400 intersection.
Easy fuel. That's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
You work on cars here?
No, sir.
Know anybody who does?
Not local, no. Huh.
The manager said the station opened in the spring of 94. He says he believes they broke ground around midsummer of 93.
So he might have just put girls underneath
that?
I heard
you tried to get some product, didn't you? I asked around about you.
In Milwaukee.
You checked out.
Everyone knew someone who knew someone who knew you and spoke highly of you. That's nice. But no one could remember laying eyes on you directly. What do you make of that?
They need to get out more.
Do you have kids?
How was your week, Larry?
Just asking. Can we try on, like, role reversal? Isn't that therapeutic?
And what would you say to me if you were my doctor?
Bitch, tell me your dreams.
I bet they smell good. Your children.
What the fuck?
You seem agitated.
I'm perfectly fucking fine. It's the best mood I've been in for years. I need to retire and have tea with your daughters. I'll watch them bend over to do their gardening.
What's making you feel so good?
My appeal.
I don't know who this girl is. They keep showing her throughout this whole entire, like, show so far. Like, it started out with her and everything, like, and I don't even know what's her...
This episode?
Yeah, like, she victim to, or what? Or she's gonna be the girl they find underneath the gas station.
Maybe.
You don't remember this?
No, I remember. This is where I, like, started dozing. But anyways, I remember they got in here and they gave him the photo.
Help you?
Are you John Dickey Hansen?
Well, you can call me JD if you like. You ever meet this guy? Oh, that's Larry.
So you know him well?
No, miss. Oh, he's as creepy as all fuck, you know? Excuse me.
No, speak freely.
I had that look of somebody who'd never been hugged, not even as a baby. Started
See?
Just hanging around.
That's fine.
Talking up the young girls.
Anything ever happened?
Why do you run him off?
He made too many of the girls uncomfortable, including my own.
Okay. He's been very helpful. The most helpful.
Yeah.
Wow. I want to learn how to knit too.
My sister and I got new sneakers.
That's probably her story then, huh?
And almost immediately, we stepped in cowboys. Even though our parents told us to stay clear of that field.
Man. The way he dialed, that's so weird. Dialed with his thumb. Uh-oh, smell trouble.
Oh, man.
Hang up the fucking phone!
Whoa. That was scary. Oh, God, I do not like that cop guy.
Oh, shit. Snitching on him.
Here comes the storm.
How about if I give you the credit card right here, right now, over the phone? Would you be able to connect me then? I appreciate you trying to help.
Really good.
Yeah.
Tony said that you almost got into a fight today. At the phones?
If some kind wanted the phone.
It's not nothing. James, come on. It's me.
It was about you, Larry. He said you're a kid killer.
He's a what?
A kid killer.
Kid killer.
So, what did you do?
I had sex with them.
Okay.
And they weren't children, James. Not until recently. I mean, not back in the 1800s.
He probably did it with them when he was in his cosplay.
Oh,
so that
so
way
he
don't feel
that.
So guilty.
James, how many women have you fucked?
Totally sure and fair.
Is it
That's not funny, Jack. Is it 80?
Yeah.
How?
I don't follow, Larry. I'm sorry.
No woman will ever just talk to me. She was nice at first.
Who was nice?
Jessica Roach. Girls think they're so smart, but there she was with a flip. They make it sound like I jump on these girls, James, and attack them. That's not reflective of the truth. She liked talking to me. Why are you asking?
Chill, Larry. I thought we were just talking.
Is that what we're doing? I told her about reenactments. And she asked really good questions. You know, she's so curious and so smart. And so I kissed her. And that's when she turned mean. Just awful, slapping me and hitting me. And I just had to rag her with the starter fluid.
Yeah, sex with me.
I knew you were gonna ask that. No, it's weird. I don't totally remember. It was like I blacked out, but then it was like I was in a dream where I see myself beating on her and ragging her, beating on her and ragging her. I want my mommy. Just take me to my mommy. I did not like that. It made me mad. It ruined everything. And I have made this a tool, I guess, that I had made by putting two leather belts together. I had this stick, but I told her to sit down with her back against the tree. I didn't want to see her face, you know?
Yep, he has guilt doing it.
And I just started twisting it like one of those,
tourniquet.
What do you call it?
Tourniquet.
Tourniquet, exactly.
Oh, God.
Yeah. I just kept twisting until she stopped making the...
Oh, God, you could tell he's pissing him off, too.
You know.
Well, it sounds like you did what you had to do.
Other times, you just sit at one of the picnic benches and just stare. Hey, Beal, did you know that most cleaners contain lye? And then he'd want you to go to his van and look at the list of ingredients. Did you ever go? Fuck no. Then when he started to give me stuff.
He gave you stuff?
Pair of earrings once. There is one thing that I didn't throw away. Last time we ever saw him, he gave me that. I never wrote it, not once.
The bike!
Every time I look at it, it makes me want to take a shower.
Oh my goodness.
But my biggest pork chop, the one I obsessed over and had to wait until my 13th birthday for, and still work off 5 months' allowance to get, was a mountain bike.
That's good girl, yeah.
Oh my goodness. Her name is Jessica something.
I did the math.
Oh, that's the girl.
I lived over 5,000 days. Over 135,000 hours. All that time was mine. You can die, but you can't unlive. I lived. Here. 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 And here. It was great.
Not enough. It's bullshit. What is the serial number of the bike?
Someone burned it off with acid.
There's no way to conclusively prove that this is Jessica Roach's. Unless matching fingerprints of both Hall and Roach found on. Not even close.
Better call your buddy.
You work here. You did. This is top fucking notch. You did. But it's not enough.
What would be enough?
I don't know. This ain't it.
A confession?
Call your guy, man. Call your guy. Oh, man, he was gonna throw up. That's so sad.
James.
Goodness, he is good. He is so good. Oh my goodness. Oh. His dad at the end too?
Yeah.
Oh God, that's killing me.
I'll wait for you to come back. We'll do a final discussion. Yeah.
Hi. Hi. I'm Norah.
But yeah, no, this episode was really good.
Like, right from the beginning, it got me with the funeral home. Like, yeah. I just wanted to freaking cry so hard.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, no. That
hit. Part was really, really hard for me.
Norah. No. Come here.
And then right to a point, he's like, he said her name, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Dude. I feel so bad for him.
I know. I had a hunch that the little girl that we've been following was the same girl with the bike.
Okay.
Jessica. Uh-huh. But I just wasn't sure. But we just kind of like, pretty much we just got her story. Oh, man.
All right, good job.
In the conversation, you can see Jimmy was just trying his best to hold everything together.
He was like,
yeah, he was like, oh,
grinning.
God damn it.
Oh, man. At the end, though, when he cried, yeah. Oh, I can feel it.
Yeah.
I'm just absorbing all his pain and just feeling scared for these girls that he hurted. And my goodness. And then the way he said that she cried for her mom, like, oh, my God. Goodness, and he turned his belt. Oh, no, not belt, but his.
He puts two belts together to
two
make
belt.
It bigger.
Okay.
So that he can put it around the neck, and then he puts a stick in between. And he just
turns it like a tourniquet.
Yeah. God damn.
That's.
Yeah.
Scary deep.
Yeah. Well, this is the second to the last episode. Next week will be the last one.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
All right.
Yeah.
I want to watch again right now.
All right, we'll see. Okay, well, that's the end of this episode. We'll go ahead and see you guys next week. See you guys. Bye-bye.
Get your phone.
Let me stop.